So I'm going to take you through what I would call the whirlwind of masking. And so starting from the least protective, going to the most protective. So this is a cloth mask. We know that this is going to be the least protective that we have because, again, as most cloth have, they have smaller little holes in them. So you're going to have more particles going in and out. The next best option from the cloth mask then would be a surgical mask, which again is medical grade in the sense that you have less of the holes inside of there. So you're going to have less particles coming in and out. Then we'll go into the category of what we would call N95s. And so these are the hospital grade, healthcare worker grade versions of what I'm wearing. But also, we also know now that the CDC is actually going to be giving out our national stockpile to let people who want N95s to actually make that available to people at home too. So the thing about an N95 is that it is NIOSH rated. So you'll see there's a little thing on here that says NIOSH. That's basically saying that it's been standardized. This is an N95, means that it's going to filter out 95% of the particles. But I think the most important thing for people to remember is that you'll have a headband on here. And so you can have this version, which is my favorite one. You can have the hard shell version, which I've worn for many hours at a time, but again, not quite as comfortable. There's a duck bill version as well, and even a moldable version. This is probably my favorite version. But the thing that's important about these is that snug fit. So making sure that you have a good fit, the nasal bridge is tight, and that you're not, when you're exhaling, you're not feeling air coming out of the side. That's going to be really important. The next level up that I would say too, or I should say similar to the N95s, are the KN95s and the KF94s. KF is short for Korean standardization for a 94% mask that has been standardized, we know, to filter out 94% of the particles. So if an N95 is not available, because a lot of us healthcare workers are using that, the KF94 is the second best option. The third best option is the KN95. And the reason that that's the third best is that the CDC did a quick study looking at how many of these KN95s truly are filtering out 95% of the particles, and only about 60% of them were. There's not as much standardization that comes out with these KN95s, and so you have to just be very careful about that. But the big difference between the KF94, the KN95, is that they're going to have the loops behind the ears rather than the headband, so they're not going to fit as snugly as the N95s do. That was a lot. So, but ultimately, what you have to do is find the mask that fits the best for you, and you have to feel comfortable in the situation that you're in. So, a mask is just one layer of protection. But if you're in a crowded space and you're not socially distanced from others and you've got poor ventilation, that mask is not going to be able to keep you completely safe. So, I want to say that this is one of many other strategies that's important in staying healthy.